عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وأهله وصحبه وبارك وسلم عليه. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد إنما يريد الله أن يذهب عنكم الرجس أهل البيت وفي مقام آخر ولا تكونوا لمن يقتل في سبيل الله أموات بل أحياء ولكن لا تشعرون. صدق الله مولانا العظيم وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم الأمين. قال رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وأهله وصحبه وبارك وسلم عليه حسين مني وأنا من حسين أو كما قال الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وأهله وصحبه وبارك وسلم عليه. حمد و ثنا کے بعد میرے واجب احترام بزرگ اور دوستو السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. اللہ تبارک و تعالی جل جلالہ امن والہ کا لا تعداد ان گن بے شمار شکر ہے کہ ہمیں اشرف المخلوقات میں سے انسان پیدا فرمایا, اور صرف یہ نہیں بلکہ ہمیں آقا انعامدار تاجدار مدینہ فخر موجودات احمد مصطفیٰ محمد مصطفیٰ صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم کے امتی بنایا. ایک شاعر نے کیا خوب فرمایا ہے, فرماتے ہیں کہ نہ مسجد میں نہ مندر میں, نہ مسجد میں نہ مندر میں, نہ کعبے کی دیواروں میں, نماز عشق ادا ہوتی ہے تلواروں کے سائے. مائی بروز اسلام, تھینک یو مائی اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی تھرو دا گریس آف ہز بیلوڈ حبیب محمد مصطفیٰ صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم who has brought us together الحمدللہ on this great day of یوم الجمعہ, a day which was allocated because of our Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Because the main point, focusing point, the main reason of our religion is the love of Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam says, a Juma, a day of Juma, when the Muslims come together, it is a form of showing love to each other. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept us coming here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the hidayah to follow upon the footsteps of our Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. It is stated that when a person, he lives in the dunya, in this world, every single action of his is done to please Allah. And why do you want to please Allah? Because Allah promised you one thing, which each and every one of us, every single day, every single night, we yearn for that one thing. Allah's Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the greatest Nabi. Why we even understand that he is the greatest Nabi? That our beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam has stated that Allah took me and went to Masjid al-Haram, Masjid al-Aqsa, and Allah took me to that place where nobody could reach. You see, when Allah's Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam was going to that place where nobody could reach, Jibreel Amin was with him. Right up to that point, which is known as Sidratul Muntaha. After that point, there's no right, there's no left, there's no up, there's no down. There's no white, there's no black, there's no red, there's no color. Out of our mind, out of our understanding. When something is out of our mind, out of our understanding, you will say that is a miracle. And the greatest miracle of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam was that night. Jibreel says, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is my last point. After this I can't go. You say, why? Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are made of noor. Nabi alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, you are also made of noor. Jibreel says, aage wahi ja sakta hai jiska utna noor. Yani where Jibreel's reality, where his greatness ends, that is the beginning of the greatness of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa. Then my Nabi says, hey Jibreel, did you remember that time when Ibrahim alayhi salam was going into the fire? You went to him and said, is there anything, last words that you have for Allah? Because I can go to that place where nobody can go. He said, my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came after that. How many years after that? Allah says, wal afdalu wal akhiru wal zahiru wal batin. But my Nabi was watching. He said, Ya Jibreel, do you remember what you said to Ibrahim? Now you remember what I am saying to you. I am going to that place where even you can't go. You see the karam and the reality of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَن يُزْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ أَهْلُ الْبَيْتِ. Allahu Akbar. Each and every one of us are striving for that one ni'mat. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I will show you myself. So what do you want to go into Jannah for? The only reason you want to enter Jannah, not for the who's. Well, that will come in between. But the reality of entering Jannah is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises you, oh you who have brought iman, oh you who are mu'mineen, I promise you when you come to Jannah, I will show you myself. That's all. But Ya Allah, when that person who fights in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he goes into Jannah, Ya Allah, what happened? Allah will go to them and say, yeah, tell me those who are the shuhada. Have you found whatever you wanted? I am also in front of you. Is your heart satisfied? He says, Ya Allah, I make only one dua. That Allah must send me back on the earth and let me die in the sake of Allah subhanahu. That the lizzat, the sweetness of giving your life in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so great, wallah, that they want to give it over and over and over again. This is where you're standing now. Next week, inshallah, will be Muharram, the starting of our new year. You say, Islam zinda hote har Karbala ke baad. That Islam comes alive after every Karbala. But why? Every other religion, wallah, they rejoice. It's our new year. Good things. But Allah's Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed us that the starting of our Islamic year starts with sacrifice. So no matter who you are, where you come from, how great you might be, But if you do not sacrifice yourself for the sake of Allah and His Rasul, Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's not a good year for you. I will start with sacrifice. We say to ourselves, Ya Allah, I give my soul, I give my body, I give everything to you. Say, why you do that? Say, Ya Allah, we love my Nabi. What my Nabi says? The Sahaba Ikram went to my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulallah, what can we do for you? You gave us so much. You gave us iman. You gave us and showed us the way towards Jannah. Ya Rasulullah, what can we do for you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, Kulla as'alukum alayhi ajran illa muwaddata fil qurba. I want to listen to this verse very carefully. Because you must remember, those that took out their swords in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala were people who had love for Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam and the family of Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And those that came against them were also the people that read the kalima La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Kafir ki baat nahi hai. Kafir is one thing. إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ أَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ Who are the munafiqeen? You think not? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Oh, you will believe, if you want to do something for my Nabi, the Quran, you must love those that are close to him, yani the family of Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Jo Quran mein aaya hai, sunnat hai ki farz hai? The love of Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his family is farz upon us. Anyone who doesn't have love for Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he doesn't have nothing, wallah. Yani kalma la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Uske par amal to karo. Have full iman on that. You believe in Allah is one. And you believe in Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, who is the Nabi of Allah. That's all. Islam finishes? No. When you enter Islam, you must enter Islam completely. And how else can you enter Islam completely if you don't have love for Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wasalam? Then Allah says, Kul, La as'alukum alayhi ajran. Say to them, you don't want anything from them. Kisi cheez ki zarurat nahi hai. Kul la as'alukum alayhi ajran illa muwaddata fil qurba. But the love that you have for those that are close to me. Now you're telling me those that pull out the sword are true Muslim. Ke munafiqi. Munafiq. They read the kalima. But still you went against Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam family. And who? Not anyone. They went against Imam Husain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who Allah's Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Husain minni. Who are Nabi Husain? My blood in Husain's blood is safe. Husain minni, Husain is from me. Mutse. Who are Nabi Husain? And I am from Husain. But take one again. Where's the difference? Allah's Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loved Imam Hussein so much that he even loved Imam Hussein more than his own son. Again, you that hadith. Say, Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam, one day he had Hazrat Qasim radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that child we had from Maria Qibtiyah radiallahu ta'ala anha, on one shoulder. Imam Hussein on the other shoulder. And Jibreel comes and says, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, Allah will not leave both of them with you. Allah has sent me for you to make the choice who you want and who don't. They say, ikhtiyar in Nabi? What is the ikhtiyar? Where Allah's Nabi got power? They say, Hazrat Ali karam Allah wajhul kareem, one day, they were coming back from a ghazwa, from a war. And in that war, it was a time of Asr, And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he saw Ali sitting under a tree. He went and he put his head on top of the lap of Hazrat Ali karamallahu wajhah. Imagine to have Dono Jahan in front of you. That Nabi who is even more beautiful than the moon. That Nabi for whom the moon was made. And everything else in the dunya was made. Nabi got no power. I show you. Hadith, authentic hadith. Bukhari Sri, Muslim Sri hadith. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam when he put his head on Ali's lap. Some people say, some ulama say that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam keelula farma rahe thi, he was sleeping. But I say no. Was that a time for anyone to sleep? In between the time of Asr and Maghrib is a time for you to walk around, explore. Not the time to sleep. Sone ki waqt nahi tha. You could not rest in that time. Allah's Nabi was testing the iman of Ali karamallahu wajhahu kareem. So Ali said, he never read his Asr namaz. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam had performed his Asr namaz. Now he sees the sun is going down. Suraj niche jala. Can't move now. Move Ali! His muhabbat is gone. What can you do? Aslul ibadat, the reality of your ibadat is the love of Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ali never even moved. And then he says that came into his heart so much that Ya Allah, my namaz go, never mind. My Nabi is listening, mustn't sleep, mustn't. And it hurts him so much that wallahi says Ali from his eyes one drop of tear fell. Nabi to sota nira. He wasn't sleeping. That one drop of tear fell on the face of our beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, my Nabi woke up. So, Ya Ali! Ya Allah, what happened? Being in the company of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What Sharia says? Do you know what Sharia says? Why we say that the love of the Ahl al-Bayt, the family of Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the love of Allah's Nabi is farz upon us. Why? Because when you are busy with the hukum of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's ibadat. Say if you're reading your namaz, in your second rakat, no matter what namaz it is. Zohar, call it Zohar, for example. Second rakat you are in. Nabi calls, immediately you leave your namaz and go. Do what Nabi wants. And they say when you finish, you can go back and carry on from where you left it. Not from the front, from where you left it. So the ikhtiyar of my Nabi is this. The power. He said, Ya Ali, this is what? Such a small thing. Wait. My Nabi took his shahadat finger. And he brought that surah, that sun back. Now, the question is, now the sun that he wants to know now, do you want to know that the sun now it came back because of kiske liye? Ali? It came for Ali. Now when will the sun go down? Jab tak Ali namaz na pade, us waqt tak us suraj nahi dubega. He said, every single day when I come out for the dunya. But today I came out for Ali. And who brought it back with one finger? Ikhtiyar of my Nabi. If anything can change in the dunya, if your life or if you're going to Jahannam, if it can change in this dunya, it can only change by our beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So I was saying that the love of the Ahl al-Bayt and Imam Husain radiallahu ta'ala anhu is farz upon us. And they showed us that no matter what, no matter how much of hardships come on you. You know, we read the Quran the other day. What the Quran says? يَكَادُ الْبَرْكُ يَخْتَفُ أَبْصَارَهُمْ كُلَّمَا أَضَاءَ لَهُمْ سُوفِي وَإِذَا أَظْلَمَ عَلَيْهِمْ قَامُوا وَلَوْ شَاءَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ كَدِيرٍ. You see, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends the thunder and the lightning, when the thunder comes, it is dark. These munafiqeen, they stand quietly. But when the lightning comes, they start moving. They see light. It means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about azab. When the azab comes on them, they don't know how to handle it. When they see a little bit of light, then they want to move. But those that are mu'mineen, the lovers of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, when muskil and things that are hard comes upon you, you'll be like Ayyub alayhi salam. If anything get destroyed, you say, Allah gave, you give again. Yeah, push me. But the love of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, barqarar. So let's look at the greatness of Imam Husain radiallahu ta'ala. Time is very short. I'll give you two waqiyah inshallah if I can. It is said that my beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, one day he was relaxing in his aunt's house, Salma. And then the next morning, Salma comes to Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam, she's crying. Saru katabura. He said, Deka, what happened? Waqiyah, ma huwa? So, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, I saw a dream. They all understood in their hearts, in their minds, in their lives, in their iman, that anything that is attached to my beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam can never be wrong. Even if you see my Nabi in your dream, shaitan can't take his place. Nothing can take the face of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you saw him, you saw him Allah. So she says, I saw Ya Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, a piece of meat from your body was cut out and it was placed on my lap. Allahu Akbar. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, that is a good news. What a chakwabe. Husainun minni. وَأَنَا مِنْ حُسَيْنِ Husain is from me and I am from Husain. The piece of meat got cut. He's happy. He says, a child will be born from my daughter who will play in your lap. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam started crying. Say, Ya Rasulallah ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, ma huwa? What happened? He was happy. A child coming into your life, into your home. Ata'a Jibra'il. Wa turbati turbati amra. Jibra'il alayhi salatu wasalam came to my beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Ilmi ghaib, he didn't have to say. He said, Jibra'il came. He brought the sand of Karbala. And he told me that those that have read my kalima are the ones that will make my Husain Shaheed. Time is coming. But the barakat of the Ahlul Bayt, especially Imam Husain, is so much that if Allah's Habib says that he is so close to me, that he runs in my blood and my blood runs in his, one day my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he's holding Imam Husain in his hand. God made it. Jibreel Amin says, Ya Allah, give me permission to go to my Nabi and give him Mubarakbad. Mubarakbad there. He got a grandson like Imam Husain. He said, Bismillah, you go. Jibreel is coming. He comes to the seventh Asman. And he sees an angel who was in charge of 70,000 angels. Siddhartha, all his wings, burned. Say, what happened? Why are you like this? He said, no, Ya Jibreel, the time when my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam was going on Miraj, each and every angel that stood up in respect of Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I got later set down. Allah's azab and his anger was so much that wallah, my wings are all burnt. Where are you going? Today I'm going to the Bargah of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Maybe God asked for safarish. My Nabi's dua, you'll get it back again. His name was Fardas, that angel. So he came with Jibreel alayhi salam. When they came to the Bargah of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there he sees Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam carrying Imam Husain in his lap. Awraq-e-Azam, the kitab. He says, Jibreel explains the whole kissa. What happened to Fardas? Fardas make salam, make mubarak baad. This ko kya hua? Say, Allah had burnt all his wings. Say, Asha, hey Fardas, take your body, wa massa, jisme, Husain, take your body and rub it on the body of Imam Husain. Allah will give you those wings back. He rubbed his body on the body of Imam Husain, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him his maqam again. And when the time of Karbala came, he went to Allah and he was asking, begging Allah, Ya Allah, send me on the earth. Let me go and fight in the way of Imam Husain, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Allah says, no, wait. When the battle of Karbala was over, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, hey Fardas, take your forge, your army and go now and cry. Cry so much and give the sawab of each and every tear to those ummatis who feel sad at the time of Muharram and give them so much of sabr wallah that they hold Deen-e-Islam right on the top. Now we're seeing every year people say, what is your New Year's resolution? They got bucket. No, what bucket? They put a note in the bucket. I'm going to do this. Naya sal mein ye karega, ye karega. Na mithai mat jo rota hai liye mere. Insaan ka fitra kaise? What is your New Year's resolution? The shayari was saying, na masjid mein, na mandir mein, na masjid mein, na mandir mein, na kaabe ki diwaron mein. نماز عشق ادا ہوتی ہے تلواروں کے سائے میں. The month of Muharram that is coming, wallah, it teaches us one thing. Yes, we can say we can blow hot air every single day of our life. We love Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We love him. We'll give our life for him. But فرض نماز ہی رکھتے. ارے مومن بننا ایک بات ہے, مسلمان بننا ایک بات ہے. You become Muslim to become mu'min. When you become mu'min, you have complete love and devotion for my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if you do not act upon that act which Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his whole life never left out. You know, on the battlefield of Karbala, when Imam Husain went on the battlefield, you know, they killed how many of those people? I would say munafiqeen al munafiqeen fil tarka, they're worse than kafir. This ke andar muhabbat hai مصطفیٰ نہ ہو, جس کے اندر محبت اہل نبی نہ ہو, وہ تو جہنم ہی ہے. من احب اہل بیت مات شہیدا ومغفورا. If you die with the love of the اہل بیت in you, you will die as a مغفور, as a person who is forgiven, a person who is a شہید. Look at the مقام. But have bughs in your heart, have enmity in your heart, where you go? Jahannam jai. Why? Because the farz upon you. That is Islam. That is the reality of Islam. No matter where you come from, no matter what you are, if you do not have that love to that degree, wallah, your namaz is not accepted, nothing is accepted. Imam Husain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, what he said? On that battlefield, wallah, that sword was shining so much. A sword, Zulfiqar. So keep name for the sword. Zulfiqar, wallah, he was turning that he right and left. It was said that Imam Husain radiallahu ta'ala, if he did not be stopped, Umar bin Saad says, if we do not stop him, wallah, we would not, one of us would be left. But the sword stopped on its own. Why it stopped? It was the time of Zuhr Salah. The life could go. By the time of Salah, where Allah is calling you, for Hazrat Ali Karam Allah Wajhul Kareem, those tears that came out was for Salah. My Nabi had taught us like. My Nabi gave us the tarbiyat like. Hazrat Ali Karam Allah Wajhul Kareem. name is Husain. He said one day that arrow went in his leg. Arrow. You have to pull an arrow from your leg. You know, we think we don't know what is battlefield. You know, when you see blood splattered on the ground, hand coming out one side, leg coming out one side. Some people say you fight for blood. That's why you don't look at money. You see the blood, you fall down. Hey, what? You're a man. Allah says, sacrifice for me. Sacrifice your life too for me if you have to. So he says, that Hazrat Ali, Karam Allah, was of Kareem, he says, take that arrow out when I'm in my salah. He said, why, Ya Ali? He said, when I'm in my salah, my whole wujud, my whole body, everything. As-salatu miraj al-mu'mineen. That salah, your namaz is a miraj of mu'mineen. Is it time to meet Allah? When I am engrossed in my Allah, I do not feel anything in the bottom, then pull it out. And they used to pull it out. Imam Husain radiallahu ta'ala on the battlefield. He says, hey Shiba, wait, let me read my namaz, then do what you want to do after that. So can read your namaz. Won't a Musliman become? Eh? Musliman. La ilaha illallah Muhammad. We can read namaz behind anyone. Akal ke ando. Understand what I'm trying to say. You cannot become lakir ke fakir. We all read kalama. But who acts upon the kalama? If you don't follow the hadith, you don't follow the Quran, wallahi, how are you going to read that salah? How are you going to act upon that salah the way that Allah wants you to do so? If you do not have love for Nabi Muhammad and Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in your heart. Because those acts can only come out with love. Otherwise, forget it. Then you'll be up and down, up and down, up and down. You know, they say that any one of us who finds our namaz hard and to read it in a proper time, you know why you can't do that? It's because you must go and look back in your life itself. You are doing something and you are eating something which is not right. They say that when you eat something that is halal, wallah, it elevates you in the status of Allah. And you eat one drop of haram that is mixed with the whole pot of halal, makes everything haram. So be careful. The time we are living in is very, very nazuk. Nazuk meaning very soft in the sense that your iman can go very quick. Have love for the Ahlul Bayt. And the actions of the Ahlul Bayt was that salah. That kept them strong. See, Allah is going to ask you about salah. Yes, He'll ask us about salah. But first we have to have iman, complete iman before we read that salah. If you have the iman, why not read the salah? Nabi loved that salah. For that salah, Imam Husain radiallahu ta'ala said, stop. He went down and read his namaz. But when he went down in sajida, that shimal layin, munafiq. He takes a sword and he removes the sar mubarak of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam grandson. And where was that namaz ish? That's why the child says, na masjid mein, not in a masjid, na mandir mein, not in a temple, na kaabe ki divarum, not even in the walls of the kaaba. Namaz ish, the namaz of love and muhabbat. You know, muhabbat is one thing, ishq is something else. Huh? You know what is ishq? Ishq is when you forget yourself. Only thing is, there is that thing or that person that you love. That is ishq. So he said, when that ishq comes inside you, the namaz that you are going to read, that namaz will only be with love and muhabbat. And when you read that namaz with muhabbat, the greatest form of act and that was done by anyone in this world was that namaz that Imam Husain radiallahu ta'ala anhu and gave his life for the sake of Allah and his Rasul Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam for the religion that you and I have. But we say that the azan is going, yeah, the TV is there, let's watch the movies after the religion. Imam Husain gave his life. And the actual muhabbat of that namaz was done under the saya, the shadow of his sword. Just before his life could go, he saw the saya, the shadow of that sword on top of him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the hidayah to understand the greatness of the family of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam and make us better Muslims for the future. Just one thing I would like to say. You know, the Ahlul Bayt, whatever Allah's Nabi had was passed down to the family only. And from the family it went to everybody else. I want to mention one waqiyah of my ustad, Sayyid Ghulam Muhyiddin Shah Sahib, on whose name we built this place. Hasni Husaini Sayyid, mother side Imam Hussein, father side Imam Hassan. Hasni Husaini Sayyid. And it was the early days of our studies in Pakistan. Yeah? And he came down to South Africa to visit. The first time my father, Allah give him Jannah, had an opportunity to drive Shasa to Ladysmith. And he told me this himself. And then, as he's driving and going, he drives the old Mercedes Benz, you know, he's a Mercedes Benz. He says, Hazrat, look at that car there, how fast. Look how beautiful it is. But yours is also beautiful. I've got a child. He says, no, no, man. You're sitting with me, don't worry about me. You'll see, just now you'll buy another one. Well, now, from that year, right till the year that my father passed away, every single year, he had a brand new model of a Mercedes Benz. That's why they say, ishq is that maqam. Dua to dur ki baat hai. When the people of Allah and the people of the Ahlul Bayt, when they reach that maqam of ishq, that height of ishq, like dua karna to dur ki baat hai. Sochte Allah unko nawaz de. They only have to think it and Allah gives it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding of that, the love of the Ahlul Bayt, and make us better Muslims for the future, inshallah. I did start a week earlier. There's one reason for that. That the battle of Karbala, the waqi of Karbala, is so vast, wallah. To cover each and every point is very difficult for us. And I'm going to try again, inshallah, like every year. We have the 10 days program. Try and be present, inshallah. Each and every day we'll give you the waqi of exactly what happened in the battle of Karbala. To the sarka and wasila of our Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our Ustad Sayyid Hasiruddin Shah sahab, Damul Barakatum Al-Aliya, Naib Ghawsi Azam, we had that beautiful experience that whenever he used to teach hadith, wallah, he used to take you away. Meaning that one day he was giving the hadith on Muharram and he was talking about the battle of Karbala. Wallah, each and every one of us in the class, we went to the battle of Karbala. I could smell the blood of Karbala. I could hear and feel the blood falling everywhere next to me. And he brought us back to where we were. This is the karam of the Ahlul Bayt. May Allah give us the muhabbat, inshallah. May Allah, through the muhabbat of the Ahlul Bayt, give us Jannatul Firdaus and give us that meeting with our beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And remember that our New Year's resolution is to turn away from that which Allah's Nabi hated and go towards that which Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loved. Ahabba Allahu wa abghad Allahu. Love for the sake of Allah and His Rasul, and hate for the sake of Allah and His Rasul, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, wa ma'alina illa al-ibadu bin, zahra al-ibadu.